Hello and welcome to Red Stapler. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect to RDS MySQL database from AWS Lambda. First, you need to have database instance running on RDS. Here's the database I have. Just only one employee table with couple rows. So I'm going to make the Lambda function connect to the database and select the first employee. We'll need to use Node.js MySQL module for this job, which is not natively available on Lambda. So we need to code and test locally and then create a deployment package and upload it back to Lambda. So let's begin with initializing the project with npm int. And then install MySQL module with npm install. We'll create a new file for local run, so let's name it local.js. Now rather than creating and managing the database connection one by one, when working with Lambda, we should utilize the connection pool instead. So when your function was invoked many times in a short period, the connection can be reused without opening and closing many times. Let's use the example code on MySQL GitHub to create the connection pool. You can get the host URL from your RDS console of your database instance. Now it's not a very good practice to hard coding these values in a source code, so I'm going to create a config.json file to hold these values. And then load the config file from the JS using require. Next, we'll use getConnection method to get the connection from the pool, and then use query method to execute the SQL. And in a callback, we will release the connection back to the pool for reuse, and then throw the errors if any, or show the selected result to the console. And finally, terminate the node process. Now let's test our code. Okay, that works fine. So the next step is to make change to our code a little bit, so it can work with Lambda. Let's create a copy of this code and name it main.js. We need to move getConnection method inside export.handler. And then replace the throw and console.log with Lambda callback function. We need to remove process.exit and replace it with context.callback wait for empty event loop equal to false. We need to do this because the connection pool remains active for the connection to be reused. And so if we do not disable this flag, the Lambda callback will wait forever for the pool to shut down and resulted in a timeout. Now we are ready. Let's create a deployment package by zipping everything you need except the local.js and then upload it from the console. Alright, that's it. Hope this helped getting started with Lambda MySQL connection. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching and bye.